So, you take, let us assume, a third toke, long and slow. You vaporize, and you take it in and in and in, and there is a sound like the crumpling of a plastic bread wrapper, or the crackling of the flame, and a tone, a there is a cheer. The gnomes have learned a new way to say who.
DMT is not an object of common experience, even among drug enthusiasts, and so a word must be said about it.
In some ways, the occurrence of DMT in our brains, in our bloodstream, is you know, kind of validation of a spiritual reality in quite a few ways.
At about minute one, close to minute one and a half, just feeling really like loose, and comforted, warm, and whatnot. Also feeling really light.
After I like exhaled, I was like, whoa. It was like hitting a wall, my body felt all fuzzy. Weird body. Really weird.
And
body.
I take a deep breath and then I blow out the plume of smoke, and that smoke turns in green, and immediately I'm gone.
After a few lungfuls, the onset of the experience is rapid, 15 seconds to a minute. The hallucinogenic experience which it triggers lasts 3 to 7 minutes and is unambiguously intense.
I would hear a sound come up.
It's very mechanical. It almost sounded like a buzz.
The buzzing and kaleidoscopic shifting was intense and went on for a long time.
And what this is literally like a portal to the afterlife. What I describe it as, it's like complex geometric patterns that are made out of love. Like you go literally to another dimension.
DMT is the same chemical that your brain floods with when you die.
I would perceive a tunnel. That, and I would perceive myself sliding right down the tunnel at about a 45 degree angle. And I could see at the very end, I could see it was light at the end.
This feeling of as if I was taking off on a roller coaster, going straight forward extremely fast. And while this feeling of shooting forward was overcoming me, I started seeing things.
And I realized there's a whole bunch of these tentacles now, and they're completely in the same space that I'm in. And I realized that, oh my god, here I am again.
Close my eyes, and it was like whole new realm.
Walls, such they be, are crawling with geometric hallucination.
If you saw a movie and there was a substance in this movie that existed in every single ecosystem, it's in plants and it's everywhere. It's in grass. And you take phalaris grass and you extract it and you get DMT from it, literally. I mean, it's in more plants than it's not in. And if there was a drug that allowed you, if you smoked it, you could literally see God, literally have a communication with pure wisdom. Wouldn't you think that everybody would have heard about that?
It's one of the most unexpected aspects of the study's results was the frequency.
Over half the cases of DMT had involved contact
with these intelligent, as an
extra-dimensional thing that's all these different shapes, kind of like glowing, flashing, and changing colors.
Different shapes and different geometric patterns, and everything was kind of whooshing and winding and spiraling and pulling me in but pushing me back.
It was extremely friendly, and I felt a warm, sensual energy radiating throughout the hive, like McKenna says, they're friendly elves. And I decided it must be a wonderful thing to live in a loving and sensual environment such as that. It said to me that this was where our future lay.
I am next at the center of the universe, and I'm watching, literally, I'm watching all information that is known being sucked through a black hole.
To a place where I understood something about myself.
It was such a profound experience to have been out there in deep space. And I'm not the kind of person that would have expected.
I would say it was an implicit reality. It was like more real than anything else I could name to you right now. It was like, it was not like looking at it, right, but being it.
Everyone has said that when they're in that state, when they take the drug, they're not intoxicated, like they're just completely sober.
And essentially, it's the universe coming awake to itself. I think that consciousness permeates reality, and that what we're seeing is, you know, the sentient universe in a way, in the process of waking up to itself.
Oh, my God.